सो एबिलिटी इज नथिंग बट सेल्फ बैलेंसिंग और हाइट बैलेंसिंग बाइनरी सर्च ट्री. ओके, दैट इज ऑल एबिल ट्रीज कैन बी बाइनरी सर्च ट्री, बट नॉट ऑल बाइनरी सर्च ट्रीज और एबिल ट्रीज.
कैन
यू
बी
कुड सी द डिफरेंस, यू कुड रियली
एवरीथिंग।
अंडरस्टैंड द डिफरेंस. ओके,
यस मैम,
या ओके. एंड नेक्स्ट वील सी वन मोर टाइप, दैट इज रेड ब्लैक ट्रीज. ओके, एंड वॉट इज द डिसएडवांटेज ऑफ एवियल ट्रीज? वी हैव डिस्कस्ड राइट, वॉट इज द डिसएडवांटेज ऑफ एवियल ट्रीज? एनी आइडिया,
डिसएडवांटेज
वॉट इज द डिसएडवांटेजेस ऑफ वॉट वी हैव टू डू? वॉट वी हैव टू डू इफ इट इज नॉट बैलेंस्ड, वॉट वी हैव टू डू?
वी हैव टू बैलेंस मैम देन
Yeah, so for that what we are doing to balance that, what we are
रोटेशन
doing
मैम
exactly, so
रोटेशन
exactly
रोटेशन
correct, so we have to do rotation, right? So for example, in real time application, where I want to insert many items frequently, that time what will happen if I use AVL structure? Anyway, what is the purpose of binary search tree, AVL tree, everything? Actually, what is the main purpose? Searching, correct. Actually, main purpose is
Yes, ma'am.
searching. We have to minimize the searching time, correct? But if I use AVL structure, but where frequently I want to insert, frequently new items are coming, that time more rotation will happen, right? Correct.
Yes, ma'am.
So it will take what? Memory utilization will be high if I use that kind of structure where the insertion will happen frequently. So that time I cannot use AVL trees, but in some applications, okay, for example, I want to maintain train details. That time I'm maintaining train details. I want to search one train detail. So it is easy to search a detail using AVL structure. Why? A new train won't be included frequently. Correct.
हेलो
Someone asked to join, so only I unlocked the meeting. Okay. For example, if I want to know details about new train, I can easily search. But a new train details, I'm not going to insert frequently, correct? New train maybe will come 6 months once or 1 year once, like that. So that details not going to be inserted frequently. So that kind of time where insertion is not happening frequently, but searching happening frequently, that time I can use AVL trees. Understood? What the purpose? Okay, the benefits.
ma'am,
Yeah.
one question
What is the
ma'am.
disadvantage
Disadvantage of binary search tree ma'am.
Binary search tree also very perfect for searching. But what is the disadvantage there? What is the disadvantage there? Only one side of tree, if it is growing, that is the only disadvantage. Correct. It is binary search tree best for searching, everything fine. But we are not following any rules. We are not maintaining any conditions over there. So obviously, if tree is growing only one side, that time what is happening? Again, searching like in a li again, searching will become a linear search. Because skewed, we will tell right skewed tree or left skewed tree. That is why with one condition we are innovating AVL trees. Okay?
ओके ओके
Yeah.
मैम
Yeah.
वन क्वेश्चन मैम
Yeah. Yeah.
मैम इन बाइनरी सर्च ट्री मैम
Okay.
यू टोल्ड दैट वी कैन परफॉर्म ऑपरेशन लाइक
Yes.
इंसर्शन
Yes.
इन ऑर्डर ऑफ एन
Yes. Yes.
लीनियर
Order of height, not n, order of height.
यस
Because
मैम वेर एन इज इक्वल टू हाइट मैम स्टेप फॉरवर्ड टू
yes,
मिनट
yes, yes,
where n is equal to height, okay
yes,
ma'am,
yes,
and
yes,
in ma'am AVL tree
yeah,
the same operations are performed in order of log n.
log n, yeah,
Yes ma'am. So ma'am, when the AVL tree grows,
yeah,
even then the insertion and searching time complexity remains the same. Then why is it a disadvantage, ma'am?
No, no, disadvantage is what we have to perform rotation when we are inserting. Order of log n is for searching, correct?
Yeah.
Searching
Yes,
time
ma'am.
is less, but I am continuously inserting new items. So I have to continuously do the rotations. Searching will be perfectly fine because it won't have more length. But what? But when inserting, we have to perform rotation. After inserted elements, definitely it will be in balanced. That time, if we search, it will be fine. Correct?
Oh, yes, ma'am. Now it's.
Yeah.
So when we are inserting, then it will create, it is kind of a disadvantage. And
Correct.
After insertion,
searching will be
when
fine.
It becomes balanced.
But,
Yes, ma'am.
but in some real time application, I want to do frequent insertion. So that time, what will happen? So too much memory utilization, too much time it will take every time I have to do perform rotations. See, if it is 10 numbers, 20 numbers, it is fine. One minute, guys. Who's that? Pavan? What happened, Pavan? Pavan, you are sleeping. Nicely hearing songs and sleeping, Pavan. Answer me.
He left.
No, no, it's Pavan. He is not there. Okay. Okay, guys. Today we'll start with some other tree. Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
It is binary search tree we have seen. And how to construct binary search tree with that lesser, greater properties, and how to insert, how to delete. And next version of binary search trees, that is balanced, height balanced, or self-balancing binary search trees, nothing but AVL trees, where there should be level balancing among levels. And today we'll see red-black trees. Okay, red-black trees. This is also what, guys, one
Subset
minute.
Red-black binary search tree.
Exactly. Yeah. It is also.
Binary search tree.
Guys, one minute. Some other student is calling, I think. Okay, guys. So red black trees. Okay. It is also binary search tree. So what is the condition? It should be binary tree. Also, it is binary search tree. It means what?
Search tree.
That lesser greater condition is applied for here also.
Ma'am, your voice is not coming, ma'am.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Ma'am?
I'm just taking. Like to... Oh, now it is coming?
Ma'am,
yeah, ma'am.
Oh, actually, I kept in mute. Someone called, no? So, I thought it's our student. So, okay. So, it is example of red-black trees. Could you see this diagram?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So, this is an example of red-black trees where each and every node colored nodes. We'll see what are the properties. So already we have seen it is binary search tree, that is self-balancing binary search tree. We will see how it is done. Before that, we'll see the properties. What is the first property? every node has a color, either red or black. So yes, in this AVL trees, either all the nodes, either it can be red or it can be black. Okay, and what is the second property?
Root of tree is always
black. Tree always black.
Exactly.
Always black.
Root of tree is what? This is whole
seven.
Tree.
Seven.
Whole tree.
Seven.
Root of a tree, seven. That is, root of a tree should be black. Always black. In black. That is second property. What is third one? There are no...
Pawan, ma'am.
Whether it is our student or someone else. Pawan, answer me.
Nah. Pawan Reddy.
Okay. So what is the third condition? There are no two adjacent red nodes. Okay. It means what? When we are constructing tree, there should not be two adjacent red nodes. In this tree, any two adjacent red nodes? Can you see any adjacent two red nodes? Any adjacent two red nodes?
8, 11.
8, 11.
8, 11 are not adjacent.
Adjacent. Adjacent means that thing I will. No red node can have its children as red node. No red node can have its parent as red node. Adjacent, just next to it. Immediate child or immediate parent. That only we can tell it as a adjacent. Okay. See here 18 and 10 are adjacent. 10 and 11 adjacent. 10 and 8 adjacent. 22 and 26. 18 and 22. Okay. So adjacent means immediate child or immediate parent. So those two cannot be red. Cannot be both same color, but black can be. There is no restrictions in black. See here, 7 and 3 are adjacent nodes, adjacent to each other. But here I am having both are black. I can have no issues. But in same way, I cannot have both red. Understood? That is third property. What is fourth property? Every path from any node to any of its descendant null node should have the same number of black nodes. We will see. See, I'm just consider 7. From 7, I'm just coming to nil node. So how many black nodes are here in this path? How many black nodes are here? Including root node. Including root node.
Two.
That is, I'm starting from the root node. That is, I'm starting from any node. Now I started from root node till the nil node I'm checking. So two black node I'm having. In same way, I'm starting from same node. I'm just trying to find another route, another path to the nil node. How many black nodes I'm having?
Two.
Correct. And I try to check in another path. I'm again starting from this root node. I'm choosing another path to the nil node. How in this node, in this path, how many black nodes are we have? How many again black two. Nodes we have? Again, two. And two. Again, I'm starting from this node. I'm just searching in some, going in some other path to reach the nil node. In this path, how many black nodes I have?
Again, two.
Two. Understood. So, this, yes, that is what they want to convey. Every path from a node to any null node, okay, should have same number of black nodes. That is the rule. Understood? Should have same number of black nodes. So what are the four properties? Number one, each and every node should be colored. That is either
red or black.
Very good. That is the first rule. What is the second rule? The root of a tree should be always black.
Black.
What is the third point? There should not be any two adjacent red nodes. There should not be any two adjacent red nodes. And what is the next point? Every path from any node to its descendant null node. See, I can take this path, I can take this path. For example, if you consider this node, I'm just trying to come here. How many black nodes here? I'm just considering this node 10 to this
one.
Descendant null node
one. Both sides.
Same node. Again, in some other path, I'm just checking. How many black node, including root node?
One.
That is one. So if you consider any node and if you consider the path to any descendant null node, it should have same number of black nodes. These are the four very important properties. Very clear? All four properties? Everyone?
Yes. Yes,
yes ma'am.
Ayush, Ashya, others also can answer, na? Chaitra, Shiva, Kavya, Kiran, Loknath, Narayana,
yes,
Swami,
ma'am.
Maunika. Yeah.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
I'm a little bit confused on last property.
Last property. Okay, I will explain again. Yes, just listen. No issues. Okay. See, I'm just considering this node. Okay. From this node, yes, I want to travel to the null node. Okay. I want to travel to the null node. Any null node. So, can I travel like this? Yes. Can I travel
like this
to the null node? Can I travel like this? Can I travel like this to reach the null node? Can I travel like this to reach the null node?
Yes, ma'am.
Can I travel like this null node to reach the null node?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah?
Yes, ma'am.
Can I travel like this? There are so many paths are there, correct?
Yes, ma'am.
In all the path, you just count the number of black nodes. How many number of black nodes, including root node? How many number of black nodes?
Two.
Two, ma'am.
Here also you check in this path also.
Two.
This two, path, ma'am. In every path. Every path.
Every path, if you count, number of black nodes will be same. That is same number of black nodes. Understood?
Okay, ma'am.
Yeah.
If the tree will be bigger and the roots will be, ma'am, path will be more, then the property should also remain same, na, ma'am.
That is the point. That is the point when it is getting bigger. When we are checking if it violates, again, we have to do balancing these properties. Understood? So when tree getting bigger, it is not that all the time it will be same. Correct? So that time, like what we did in AVL trees, we have to do rotation, something we have done to make it balance, correct? In same way, in red-black trees also, we have some properties, we have some rules to make it is balance. Okay? We will see how it is done, we will see. But before that, you should understand all the properties. Okay? Okay. Okay. So just example, we'll see which is... red black trees examples we'll see. Okay, so just they have given many examples, one by one we'll see. First example you consider, we'll start from first rule. What is the first rule for red black trees? What is the first rule?
The nodes, the roots should always be black.
That is, first of all, it should be all the nodes should be either, all the nodes should be colored, that is either
red or black.
Red or black?
Or black.
Good. That is the first rule. Whether it is following? Yes. Perfect. Yes. And what is the second rule? Root node should be black. Yes. Root node should be black. Yes, it is black. That is second statement. What is the third statement? There should not be any two adjacent red nodes. Whether it follows?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, because there is no two adjacent red nodes. And fourth property, if I take any node towards the null node, the number of black should be same. Whether it is following, I'm just considering 20. No. Correct. All the path, if I check, the number of black node should be same. So it violates property number 4. And we'll come to next example. Whether all the node either black or red, first property is fine. Yes.
Yes, ma'am. Yes.
What
yes,
about
ma'am.
This, what about second property? There should not be any two
node black, ma'am.
Adjacent red nodes. That also yes, it follows. Third node, I'm sorry, root should be black. That also follows. No adjacent red nodes. That also follows. but again it violates the fourth property. If I consider this, towards this I have two black node, but if I go in this direction to the nil node, there is only one black node, including root node. Okay, so it violates property number 4. And here we will see, if you consider this, either black or red, yes, it is fine. Root is black, yes, it is fine. There should not be two adjacent nodes. But what will happen here? There is adjacent, two adjacent nodes, correct? So, it violates property number 3. But it is not violating property number 4. See, I am starting from here. Towards nil, it is 1. If I take this root, yes, 1 black. If I take this path, yes, it is 1 black. Okay? Yes? Understood? Whether it is root node or not root node? Understood, guys?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes,
now,
ma'am.
Now we will see this example. Whether it follows first property, either red or black.
Yes,
or whether,
ma'am.
Okay. What about second? The root node should be black. Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
What about third? There is no adjacent to red nodes. That also follows. And what about fourth one? So if I consider any node till the nil node,
follow, ma'am.
The number of black nodes should be same. Yes, it is followed. So it is perfect with black trees. And what about this tree? Check. What is the first? Either black or red? Yes. The second one? Root should be black. Yes, fine. Third is, there is no adjacent to red nodes. That is also fine. Fourth one? Considering one.
Follow, ma'am.
Yes.
Follow.
Any node towards nil node? Same number of black nodes. So all four properties are following. Correct? Guys, everyone agree with this?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So this is the main introduction you should understand. What is AVL trees? What are the properties? Why we have to, in which kind of situation we have to use AVL trees? Okay. So what is the main properties? Four properties we have seen. Each and every node, it should be, first of all, it should, while we are creating, which condition actually we want to follow while creating? Actually, which condition we want to follow while creating?
Binary search tree.
Very good. Very good. Because it is binary search tree. While inserting element, I should follow. I should follow binary search tree conditions. Then only I can go with red black tree condition. These four properties. Is it fine?
Okay, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah.
Yes,
okay.
Ma'am.
Tomorrow we'll see how to insert an element in red black tree and all. Okay.
Okay, ma'am.
Few rules are here. Nearly 7 rules are here.
Okay.
Then
ma'am.
If I understand, if you understood this, then very easy to construct the tree. I will make you to understand, no issues.